I can. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Distinguished colleagues, good afternoon. Earlier today at 8:43 a.m., the province of Abra, specifically the municipality of Lagangilang, was hit by the magnitude 7.3 earthquake. This strong earthquake was felt as far as the southern parts of Luzon, including us here in Metro Manila. Social media was abuzz with the far-reaching effects of what that earthquake, but no more than the shock is imprinted to the people of Abra, who bore the brunt of the earthquake's intensity. Information relayed to our office from the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, there was one casualty, and while 47 injuries were recorded across 6 municipalities. This is the strongest earthquake to have impacted our province in recent memory, and even the region since the 1990 earthquake in Baguio, according to PBOX Director Undersecretary Renato Solidom. This is a major earthquake, as anything beyond magnitude 7 can be devastating. Several photos have been circulating now showing the extent of the damage in various communities in Abra. Windows of homes were shattered, while walls of establishments showed cracks. Many school buildings that will be used when face-to-face classes open next month, and health facilities like rural health units responsible for the first level response in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic were also damaged. Even our Abra Provincial Hospital have shown signs of damages that patients had to be evacuated to safety. As the entire province prepared for multiple aftershocks, these multiple aftershocks occurred every 15 to 20 minutes, and our people felt more than 20 aftershocks since. Everyone was on their toes, vigilant on the possibility of another strong shaking. Moreover, communication lines are unstable, and Abreños from other places find it difficult to reach their family members. Many people were also stranded along major roads and bridges in the area of responsibility, as the earthquake have also destroyed the roads and bridges and made many of them unpassable. Power was also interrupted, further complicating reporting on the extent of the damages to the province. As a mother of 4, their safety is my utmost priority. But now, as the mother of the entire province of Abra, of all more than 250,000 residents, I am grieving for the possible lasting effects of this to their security. We need to look beyond this disaster. We are a mountainous province with the mighty Abra River twisting our terrain. We may not be able to predict when an earthquake occurs, but we can certainly mitigate its effects. We need to insulate our communities from the devastating impacts of an earthquake to household and livelihoods. I commend all LGUs, to the local police and the military and the civil society, for their quick response to come to the aid of their kakailian. I thank everyone in Abra for helping disseminate true informations on the current situation in the ground. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, I am standing here as a representative of the peoples of Abra, imploring our Kakailian, our President Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr., to extend our available assistance to the province of Abra to help us rise from the ashes to this devastating disaster. We ask him to mobilize relevant agencies like the NDR RMC, DSWD, DepEd, DOH, DPWH, PNP, and AFP, and the DOTR to help us get back on track. We are optimistic that the Father of our nation will look after us and help us get back on our feet, as we resilient Abreños have always done since time immemorial. I assure you, Abra will rise again. To echo our President's call, sama-sama tayong babangon muli. Most importantly, Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, please continue to pray for our brothers and sisters in Abra, that the Almighty God give us strength to rise from this soon. We ask for your help now more than ever. Abra needs your help. Thank you very much.